Beautiful dark bees.
Okay, so I'm Johnny Kipps. This is the Isle of Man, Castletown Isle of Man. And we're just about to look at our two top hives with nice dark Manx bees. This one has got nice dark Manx bees. The second one we'll look at has got mongrelized bees, Manx dark bees mixed with all sorts of others. Contraption on the top, like most of the rest of it, comes from your videos and your advice. So that opens up like that to put frames on. So that looks like beautiful comb, although it does look like it is joined together. That's a little one.
What's the width of your top bar?
I think it's 38 mil. Offhand, I can't quite remember, but I think that's what it is.
So what's the weather been like lately here?
Up until last week, it was quite nice and warm. So they built, but none of these have got anything in.
I see you've got some shims on here. You've got some extra spaces, so those are quite wide. Combs quite widely spaced.
Yes.
And we're now getting into some bees and a little bit of honey.
A little bit of honey.
Can I just get a close up of these nice dark bees?
Beautiful dark bees.
And there's a little bit of capped honey on there.
But not much pollen anywhere.
Not yet, because we're not in the brood area yet.
Now, Phil, you said you don't use powdered sugar anymore. Do you use water?
I don't only use water as a means of getting them down instead of smoke. I don't use any treatments at the moment, so.
Okay, so there's a bit of activity.
Down between the bars so they don't squish any bees.
Well, when we put it back,
you need a bit of a mist down there.
So now that was four moving together. But it may just be propolis. This hive, I think, is much better. The bees are much better disciplined here.
They're nice, quiet bees. There's something coming off the comb, but not in any kind of over-defensive kind of way. I notice your combs are going right down to the bottom of the floor,
yes. Which
means they've probably dug out some of your floor material.
They've taken a lot of the floor material, actually. Yeah. If I look there,
they've actually emptied it.
They've emptied
it. I'll go point the camera down there. Yeah, these guys have excavated the eco floor, and this is something I found that happens with when you use fine wood shavings or anything light enough for them to carry out. They will actually empty the eco floor, that seems to be what's happened here, because now you've got long, pointy, triangular combs. Nice patch of brood there, though. Right in the middle there. And this is, where are we now? Towards the end of September.
Yes.
So they're kind of...
middle of September.
Closing down operations for winter, really. Brood on both sides. Nice patch of honey.
Let's put it away. Keep warm, ladies.
Temperature outdoors right now, are you guessing around 11, 12 degrees centigrade, maybe a little more than that.
Yeah.
But it's not sunny.
It's not warm for them.
The ivy started now, so there's ivy pollen coming in.
That's the orange. I can't see it. It's solid, isn't it?
I tend to use the back of the hand just gently on the bees, and that will get them to move aside, and you can see what's going on underneath them. Yeah, there are some empty cells amongst the brood, but not, I don't think that's excessive. I think that's just an emerging brood that's being backfilled by the queen as and when she feels appropriate.
All right.
I shouldn't imagine that inbreeding is much of an issue here. I shouldn't think you have massive different distances between apiaries, do you?
No, there aren't very many apiaries in Castletown, but there is supposedly a drone assembly about 4 miles away, 3 miles away. But they are nice and black, aren't they?
They are consistent. And again, the brood, that's decent brood, I would say. There's nothing wrong with that brood pattern.
I'm looking to see Randy Oliver's line of pollen,
yeah.
But I don't see it.
No, I suspect that the ivy's just started here, and they're only really bringing in just enough to get by on. By the look of it.
One of the things that I'm going to be doing after the conference is bringing Clive de Brain here. Mm-hmm. To see Brawler, because he says he never sees Brawler anymore.
No, because of the miticides knock it out. And given that these are black bees, which do tend to close down their brood rearing relatively early, I think that's a pretty good brood pattern.
Would it be right that they're not making any drone cells anymore?
I wouldn't expect them to be, no. Not this time of year.
No.
And usually if you see drone cells being made at this time of year, you start to suspect that maybe their queen's not behaving very well.
And well, I would have thought that that's fairly spotty, isn't it?
Yeah, but you're right at the end of the brood nest now, I think. I think we've had four combs now with brood on, and you're probably just at the extreme end of it, and that wouldn't worry me.
Okay, good.
I'm impressed by these bees. They're nice and
lovely and gentle.
A little bit, maybe a little bit runnier on the comb than some, but not in a way that causes me any.
What did somebody tell us? Say yesterday, bees that are practicing for Ascot.
Yeah, I've had some of those. Okay, now we've got one more brood on this one, I think.
Yes, there's brood there too.
Well, you see, there's larvae in a lot of these cells here. The queen's simply filling in where broods are hatched, and I don't think that's the problem.
Looks like there was a queen cell there.
It's the sort of place you might expect a supersedure cell to. Yeah, it looks like there is. You know, looks like they may have superseded at some stage.
Is that another one there?
No. Where? No.
There's one. Yeah, there's one right in this.
Yeah, that's the one we looked at from this side.
It doesn't actually look like it's been used. It's rounded at the end rather than
having a clue on it.
And did you make this yourself, John?
Yes, I did, yeah. You're aware that Phil's put these great plans
on absolutely.
The net, which is a huge benefit for top five beekeepers. Another huge amount of honey. Yeah, Phil. Well, there's a piece of broken comb stuck in there at the bottom, and I think that's part of it.
I'm guessing that these bees are now planning on stockpiling ivy over the next few weeks for winter. Yes, as you say, they haven't got a whole lot of honey in there, but in this weather, they should be able to pack it away. I noticed as you're going that you're tending to leave gaps behind you.
From
the point of view of conserving heat, I find it's obviously it's generally better if you can to close
it.
Close
it all up.
Yeah. Also, that gives you less bees coming out, and only one working gap. There's something I think you may have put that in the wrong way around. Actually, yeah. There you go. But it's good that they're running back into the hive rather than coming...
flying around making a nuisance.
Yeah. Let's spray these down before you close up, because there's quite a few bees trapped in that gap. And what's happening here, of course, is that propolis, they pack propolis into this gap, and as you open and close the hive, if you don't scrape that propolis, you find that the spacing increases.
Yes.
Which may not be an issue at all here in these conditions.
Well, there's quite a lot of honey on that one.
Yeah, I can see some open nectar as well, which is good.
Now, there's a piece of broken comb in there.
Oh, yeah, should we fetch that out?
Which is in our way.
If you can carefully lift that comb out, I can get my arm down there and...
Take this one. You want to just hold that one?
You lift that out of the way. It's coming actually with you if you're careful. Okay, if I break it off about there, have you got it?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah.
Okay,
so let's just put that guy back, shall we? Thank you very much. You okay, Andrew?
Yep.
And these bees are very responsive to the use of water, which is good too. Because sometimes you get bees that just kind of sit there and look at you and just get wet and don't move. But these guys move down.
Is that to do with training?
Absolutely.
Socialise them to
totally,
that idea.
Yeah, yeah. I give them a good talking to and I train them to use. Yeah, like of course I do. There you go. Some sealed honey, more pollen.
Sorry, Phil. Very light. It's a bit of honey, but... Well, they're all nice black bees. There's a couple of yellows there.
Can I suggest
please use.
Because you've moved all the bars back one, then why not just move the whole, move the last two this way, leave yourself a little bit more gap, which saves you having to move everything again.
Am I not going to close over one of the holes? I guess it doesn't really matter.
Oh, yeah, you've got to watch out for your entrance holes, but
one hole's going to be over here, but it's getting cold, so I'd probably close it.
What you can do with that is just stuff some grass in it. So they can't use it anymore. And then they've still got two, which is plenty.
So, I mean, there's gaps here, but they can propolize those around. But leaving the gaps there, will that cause the possibility of cross-combing?
Well,
these guys haven't cross-combed very much, so...
They haven't, they're very good though.
So I think we can ignore that.
Personally, what I would do there is to get rid of the propolis and close up those gaps if you can, but not that you have to necessarily do that now, but
yeah,
that would be,
okay.
I think, a strategy overall, because otherwise you're going to get big fat combs that will no longer fit in the given space.
Okay, well, I'll do that on Saturday when I bring Clive here. These roofs have been effective for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I put hessian bags with Western red cedar as their winter duvet.
Right.
So each one has got two hessian bags.
Mm-hmm.
That seems to keep them nice and warm.
Very gentle, the way they're just popping in and out.
These are very gentle. Yes. Not a lot, eh? But in any event, that is the flight path.
Isle of Man bumblebee paying a visit to her cousins on the roof of the hive here. Why not the rest?
She doesn't look like she's all that active. Come on, lady. Well, yes, this was the first one, and this had the entrance in the middle. Both of them have got observation windows.
Can you look through the window?
Oh, fantastic.
I know it. But this one, I've lost a lot of cross comb in this draw.
It's certainly a strong colony there.
This one I can't deal with the same way.
Okay.
Generally, these...
Well, we don't need to go right through it.
These I have to cut out. Now here is your original eco floor. With logs and twigs and stuff like that.
Nice old nectar I can see from here. Over there.
Yep.
So that comb is going to be solid honey. They are a little bit lively at the same
time.
I'm not wearing any little veil or anything, so...
Would you like to hold that one?
No, I'm okay. They're not going for me. They're just curious.
Uncapped nectar. Now your point that you made earlier is absolutely right about leaving the gaps.
Mm.
Because these guys are having to work harder, I'm sure, to fill up these gaps here.
So your advice would be to scrape off and close every time?
Yeah.
I suppose if you do it every time, there's very little build-up.
Sure, yeah.
I need to make these a little bit longer, these. Especially with that one where the comb is going further down. This is made with larch, and it has warped a bit.
Mm-hmm.
But is that sitting flush there? Yeah, that's good. This has an eco floor as well, but the Chinese latches broke, and I arrived one day and found that the floor had subsided.
Mm-hmm.
So
there's a mesh at the very base of it.
There's a mesh, this floor, in theory, can drop down and you can clean it out. But I've had to screw it up because the latches broke.
Mm-hmm. It's quite difficult, I found, to maintain a complete seal between these. Ecoflora on the hive face all the way along.
This one is terrible, but that's terrible woodworking. That one, actually, I put biscuit joints in,
mm-hmm.
and that was a bit better.
Yeah.
That's it, Phil. Thank you for coming to visit.
Thank you for showing us.
Here we go. Back in here, Randy, or whoever's in it.
The thing we didn't have these